Hey everybody, welcome back. I made this bottle in the last video. We talked about side-fired bottles in my wood kiln, and I made this one and a few others, and I'm going to show you some tips on how I flatten these into like what I call flounder bottles. I have a paddle here, and then I have two bats that I have tied strings to basically make handles on the backside so that I can use these to flatten with as well. So we're going to get into flattening at least this one, if not more than this one, in this video, and just show you kind of how I go about doing that. And then we'll talk about the rest of the process maybe in future videos of how I go about setting these, glazing these, and setting these in the wood kiln for side-fired bottles. So let's go. All right, this bottle is still stuck to the bat, which makes it a little bit easier to do this process with. It seems that it, in drying, it has leaned to one side a little bit. I may try to get that even back up here, but not necessary. These are probably leather hard, of course, a little bit softer at the bottom than the top. And what I usually start by doing if I want to make flounder bottles, and I don't worry about getting these perfectly even as far as like if it's a little bit bigger on one side than the other, I'm fine with that. They don't have to be symmetrical, but one thing about these that is important is to make a thin bottle, because by the time I flatten this, it gets really wide in this wider in the belly section. And so that makes it so that if you make a fat bottle to begin with, by the time you flatten it, it gets really fat and kind of doesn't look right. So I make these pretty fairly skinny bottles to do this with. So like I said, I've just tied a string on the backside of these bats to work with here. And I start just kind of by pushing in on each side, and then I'm gonna kind of tilt them one way and then back the other. And then I'll spin the bottle the other direction. And then I use my paddle to kind of round those edges off. But I usually just start by just pushing in on each side and then kind of working toward the edges with each of these. That's pretty good for the first attempt on that one. And then sometimes I get a little, the bottom of the bat here kind of touches down near the foot, so I can clean that up because it's softer down there. It kind of messes that up a bit. But now where there's kind of this sharp line around here, I like to take my paddle and kind of round that. And these do over time kind of push back to the shape that they were anyway. But that flat spot, I don't like to leave that flat spot there, because that will definitely show up in the finished product if I don't kind of round those edges a bit. One of the keys to doing this is getting the right stiffness of the pot. And without you being here to feel it in person, it's kind of hard to tell you what that is. But I will say that if you do try this, you will definitely at some point do one that's too soft, and you'll do one that's too stiff. And mainly you'll know it's too stiff because as you do that, you'll split the side wide open and be like, oh, okay, yeah, I should have done that before it got to that stage of dryness, and you'll have to start all over again. But that's just part of it. And if you do it when it's too wet, the bats or the paddle will stick a little bit too much, and then you'll kind of make a mess of it that way. So a little bit more salvageable on that end, because you can figure out pretty quickly that it is too soft, and kind of wait and come back later when it's a little bit more stiff. If it gets too dry, There's not a lot you can do. I guess you could maybe spray it down. Well, if you haven't busted it yet, you could spray it down and cover it up and maybe come back to it later. But you might be better off just leaving that one the way it is and making a new one and not letting it get so dry. So, all right, there's that one. And the top is still pretty good. It's a little bit off in a direction there, but close enough that makes a fine bottle. And then, like I said, later on, I come back, I will probably glaze most of these or put a layer of slip on these, that dark slip, and then that'll be bisfired on there. And then I'll come back and glaze one side, lay it in the kiln on seashells, and I will have one of those side-fired bottles like I showed you in the last video. Hopefully, that's the plan at least. All right, here's another one that's a very similar shape to the first one. And you know, these have dried because they didn't get too wet in between, so I'm gonna work on flattening this one now. That's the only problem I have sometimes, where I've attached the strings to the bat pin holes, that little spot right there hit. I didn't realize that till just now. I saw that on the last one as well, and I didn't realize what it was until I just saw that, and I'm like, oh yeah, that's probably where I hit that little knot in the string on my pot, but it's okay, I can fix that as well. All right, now we'll get the paddle back out as well on this one.